get started. So synchronous versus asynchronous clients by example. So notice that I added the word clients here, and this is very important. This synchronicity and asynchronicity is a property of the client, the front end. The front end is a synchronous or asynchronous, right? The server can be asynchronous or synchronous as well, but we're going to discuss that in another video, hopefully. But let's get to it, right? So that's the first thing. So what is synchronous or what is the difference between synchronous and asynchronous client? So pretty sure you heard about that, but in a nutshell, a synchronous client is if I make a function call or if I made a method call, whether this is a network call or is it local call or a server fetching something, if I decided as a client, as a front end, to wait until I got a result back from the server or from that method or from that function, then I am acting as a synchronous client. So it's like, you know what? It's like, I'm going to go ahead and call this function, and I'm just going to sit down here as a function or as another method. I'm just going to sit down here. I'm going to wait for you. I'm not going to do anything. I can't really move to the rest of the code below me until I receive an answer from this function. So that's in a nutshell, asynchronous client, right? And the other end, asynchronous client, is when you make a request and you say, you know what, this is your request, and whenever you're ready, whether you failed or success, just call this function. I'm going to give you a handle. I'm going to give you a callback, quote unquote callback. And just call this function when you're ready. Let me go do my thing. I have a lot of things to do. I have a lot of code to execute, right? So I'm going to go ahead and execute it. But I'm going to call you first and then just go ahead and execute it. I don't wait. So asynchronous never waits. And asynchronous doesn't wait for a call to come back in order to execute the rest of the code. So that's just in a nutshell. So there are advantages and disadvantages of both, and we're going to explain that in the next minute or so. All right, so let's start with a synchronous example. So synchronous example, what I'm going to take as an example here is our friends here on YouTube, right? So I'm going to upload a video. So that's the concept here. So I'm going to use YouTube it's a very good example here. So my little app here, web application or desktop application, uploads a video. That's what it does, right? So you specify the title, you specify the description. I forgot to specify the actual video, right? So let's assume there is like a browse button where you actually pick your MP4 video, whatever. And then you hit upload. So that's your application. And let's say this is written in a synchronous way. So how will it behave? If it's written in a synchronous way, this is what you get, right? You will hit upload and that's it. Your screen will be blocked. You cannot do anything. You cannot just change the title. You just say upload. You have to wait. You can't do anything. My thread, my process is busy doing your thing. And what is it doing? It's calling a function and it's waiting, right? And so you can see uploading and everything is grayed out. It means it's disabled essentially, right? So let's take a look at the code here. So that's the call, and that's the method I called when I hit upload button. So upload, I'm gonna print uploading. This is also a synchronous call. And then you go and upload video, and guess what? I'm gonna get stuck here. I'm just gonna wait. And wait and wait and wait and wait. And that thread that get executing that process is gonna freeze the UI. So it's a very bad user experience, as you can see, right? And the users can't do anything. It's just like gonna wait. Once it's done, it's gonna say, okay, I'm done. Success. And it's gonna tell you whether that maybe it returns the video URL or whatever, right? So that's a synchronous example in a nutshell. How it makes sense, right? So it's a very So as you can see, benefits of this is, let's start with the benefits. Benefits, very easy code. I can read it. Anyone can read it, right? Just like you go from up to bottom, print, uploading, upload, success, you're done, right? It's very simple. Very simple to read. Disadvantages, you're blocking the UI. Users, it's not a very good user experience. Maybe you can get away with this 10 years ago, 5 years ago. right? When the web is just like, you don't mind anything. It's just, oh, I'm grateful that I have internet. Right? I'm grateful that I have an app. I built an app, right? But in these modern days, like, things are not very easy going, right? So you get grilled for any app you write. You have to be really good. Critiques. Users are very good critiques now. These users of the recent era, right? So yeah, let's move on. Asynchronous example. So what is an asynchronous example? So let's take the same application. Let's say I hire someone really good, an asynchronous author and programmer, that he says, so you know what? I want to rewrite this application that will just upload my video, but I want it to do it in an asynchronous fashion. Let's see what happens here. So I'm going to go ahead and upload, and guess what? The moment I hit upload, what is that? I got a URL back. Wow, that was fast. But guess what? My upload is not done yet. It's still uploading, but I got a URL back. And that tells me that, hey, you know what? You're ready. Go ahead and you're unblocked. You can go ahead and change your title. You can go ahead and change your description. This works. And you can see if you work with YouTube or other uploading platform, this is the user experience today. You can upload a video and you can still change the title, add tags and do fancy stuff, right? Because of the asynchronous fashion, because of the asynchronous power that this user experience has, right? So that's basically the difference between asynchronous and synchronous. Let's take a look at the code. Oh, suddenly now the code doesn't look so simple, does it, right? So there's a function called upload. There is another function called upload success. Wow, okay. I would guess if I click upload, I'm gonna get a print uploading, and then upload video will basically take a function as an input, which is basically the callback function. Over JavaScript, this is much, much better now. It's much easier using the promises or even await and async await, which acts like an asynchronous, but it also acts like synchronous, which is really pretty cool design in the latest ACMS 6. So upload success will be called only when upload video finish, right? So this is a very basic example. So it's going to be more complex than that. So there will be so you know what? I should have returned the V here, and actually I should have printed the V, which is actually the URL. So upload video in this case, what it does is immediately writes a quick record. It says, hey, no, give me an ID for this video. I just want an ID. Don't upload the video yet. Just give me an ID. It will return the ID, which is the URL, and then you can just immediately print it. So it's still a synchronous call. It's a synchronous call, but it's a very quick asynchronous call, right? It's just like the server is still synchronous, if you think about it, right? But it just immediately gave me the result, and then V is basically the video URL here, which we saw in the previous this, right? And then, but if you think about it, upload video is still doing some churning in the back end. It's just there is a thread executing and doing its thing, right? However, the UI is unblocked. So this is in a nutshell, this is the difference between synchronous and asynchronous. Guys, hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, put them in the comments below. And what do you think? What is your favorite mode of programming? Do you like synchronous programming? Do you like asynchronous programming? Nothing wrong with both, right? There's disadvantage and advantage for both, right? So advantage for this is obviously you unblock it's the opposite of synchronous, right? You unblock the UI, you can do a lot of other things, but the hard thing of this, which becomes really easier these days with the modern programming languages, is essentially it's hard to understand. It's a little harder. Now it's becoming much and much easier with especially JavaScript become really cool with the asynchronous features of like await and async features. Guys, that's it for me today. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe if you want to enjoy more software engineering videos in this channel. To become a better software engineer, just shoot me an email. My details are in the description below. And I'm going to see you in the next one. Have a good day.